All right, well, moving on. Remember TV shows like The Simple Life and Sea Change, where people leave their fast-paced city lives to enjoy a much quieter existence? Well, it seems the coronavirus crisis has forced us all to embrace a slower pace and more time at home.
Now, new research shows that we are doing more cooking and baking and families are eating together more. We've dusted off old board games and jigsaw puzzles and we're watching TV as a family again. And some older Aussies say it's like living in the 70s all over again, except for working and schooling from home. Well, the man behind that research is Mark McCrindle and he joins us now. Good morning to you, Mark. Now, it seems the lockdown has forcing us back to basics. That's a good thing. What have people been telling you about how they've adapted?
Well, there has been a lot more cooking at home. People have got creative with those ingredients. Some of those tin cans at the back of the pantry have been put to good use because Australians have been getting out less. 9 in 10 have avoided going out to public places. So that means less shopping and more meals planning, more shopping lists like the old days. And with gyms out of action, we've had people being creative in exercising from home as well. We've also had 1 in 3 Australians say that they've picked up new creative pursuits like, well, baking or some of those old handicrafts. 1 in 4 have jumped online to learn a new skill. And we've also improved our household relationships as people spend more time together interacting. So a lot of positives in all of this.
Mark, it seems we're also going a little old school when it comes to home entertainment. What have people had to say about that?
Well, because we've been spending our whole day in front of screens through online learning or remote working, in the downtime, Australians are looking to put away the screens. So our recreation time has been filled with family games nights or backyard activities. People have taken up gardening in a big way, planting vegetable gardens and the like. So we certainly have gone traditional or non-screen with some of our entertainment time as well.
Lots of people have been talking about how this, you know, the elements of this will be a good thing, that it'll force us to stop rushing around as much, at least initially, and focus on what's really important. Your research suggests that many people would be happy for things to continue in a similar way that they have.
Yeah, that's right. You know, in a lot of ways, we're all excited to get out of the lockdown and back to normal, but for many, it'll actually be coaxing them out of the remote working environment and getting back to the office. Yeah, we found that 9 in 10 Australians say that remote working will become the new normal, so there'll be a lot more of that. Now, for about half of Australians, they said it's been a challenge because they've had kids working at home or other people working from home as well. So getting the balance right is going to be key. But, you know, we have made this work. 3 in 4 Australians say they're excited to do more online or remote working into the future. So it will become something of our you know, regular period, a few days here or there, working from home, and we've shown that it can work.
Gee, it's fascinating, Mark, to hear the positive spin that so many Aussies are taking on, obviously, what has been such a challenging time here. Not everyone, though, looking on the bright side. There are some Australians still feeling uncertain about what the future might bring. What are Aussies saying through your research about their anxiety levels at the moment?
Well, they are heightened across 3 key areas, and the first and most obvious one is physical health and resilience. How are we going? Not only because of the coronavirus, but because of the flu season, because of the winter that's approaching. So that's a concern, although Australians have been going pretty well on the health side. Secondly, there's the financial side, and Australians are uncertain about the long-term implications of the slowdown and how it will impact them. But again, with JobSeeker and JobKeeper, Australians are feeling pretty good about that in the circumstances. The big one has been the emotional resilience, and Australians are starting to feel a bit fatigued there, perhaps not as buoyant as they were. Even though there's light at the end of the tunnel, you know, there's the need to keep an eye on that and to see Australians get back out to interact and to feel a sense of emotional and mental resilience in this new era.
Now, you've got a theory, and it's a good one, I like it, that drive-in movies might be ready for a renaissance.
Well, we've seen a lot of renaissances, you know, who would have thought that board games or jigsaws would make a comeback? And, you know, some of those pursuits, which can be done together, but also keeping a little bit of isolation for those a bit more insecure, might be there. Anything that keeps it simple in this new era, I think, will be that way. And so, you know, that's something you don't have to dress up for and just jump in the car, keep it safe, drive to the drive-in. There's not too many options left, but in many ways, we've seen a resurgence of the retro, and that's just one of those.
Yeah, good stuff. All right, Mark McCrindle, really interesting research. Thank you so much for telling us about it.
Thanks.